pretty good in football and track and field. My first play on a football team, I took the opening kickoff return back for 85 yards. And I was nervous and I was a young guy, but I had some success there. I was like, oh, okay, maybe I can do something myself. Maybe sports, boxing might maybe not be my thing. Maybe it's football, or maybe it's something else in academics or sports. But it gave me a glimpse that I could do something myself, that I didn't have to follow my father's footsteps. So I ran track and field as well. The coach came out to us and said, you know, we've been pretty bad at track and field for a long time, so we need some of the football players to come out and do some events for us. So let me ask you guys this. What event do you think I did in high school in track? Long jump? Hurdles. Yes, high hurdles. So the hurdles would come up to about here on me. So you know you expect high hurdles to be about 6'2", 6'3", right? No. Yeah, so I had to kind of jump over the hurdles. So I'll tell you the story about me that was kind of a defining moment in me learning that I can do things myself, kind of what defines me and finding my own path. So my first day getting out to track and field practice, I could only get over one hurdle. I run, jump, next one come up, push it down. Kept practicing. The next day, came back, I was able to get over two hurdles. Each day I got a little bit better, a little bit better. Three hurdles, four hurdles, five hurdles, six hurdles, seven hurdles. At the eighth one, I couldn't do it. All the time I was practicing, I could never make it over that eighth hurdle. So come the first track meet, my buddies in the crowd, they laughing, they're like, all right, I know Ray can get over eight hurdles, but he's gonna fall at the end. So they got the cameras ready, like, you know, we didn't have video cell phones then, we had the big crank camcorders. But they were ready to go. They were ready, I tell you. So I get down and I find out that I'm racing the state champion. I'm like, man, I'm about to get embarrassed. So I get down in here into my stance. The starter says down, on your mark, set, then the gun goes off, pow! So I'm pretty fast, so I start speeding my way through. So I'm like, maybe if I just get through the first eight hurdles fast enough, I can beat him if I just push the last two down. It was a plan. So I go over the first hurdle. Then the second one. The third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth hurdle. I glance over to the crowd. My buddy's like, here we go. Something in my heart and in my mind said, you know what? This is going to be my day. I'm not going to let this define me. I just need to get over this one hurdle. That'll be nine. And then I'll find some miraculous way to get past the 10th one. So I end up getting over the eighth one. And then the ninth one. And then the 10th one. I'm like, oh, man, this is crazy. But I think I'm going to be behind everybody. And I get through to the end of the in the line, turn around, everybody else is still running in. So something that I thought I couldn't do changed my whole perspective on believing in yourself. My self-belief kicked in right at that eighth hurdle. I ended up beating the state champion my first race out when I could never get all over those hurdles throughout practice. But the one thing that made a difference, once I got over those hurdles, guess where the hurdles were? Behind you. So that's a metaphor for life. Sometimes you gotta take it one hurdle at a time. Then once you gain the confidence, you get it over each one of these hurdles, they end up behind you. Now one of the things I use to help me when I'm struggling or going things is an acronym. James kind of stole my thunder, he had a life acronym, but mine is FAME. Not talking about Kardashian kind of fame. But FAME, it stands for focus, acknowledge, motivate, educate, and take action. Actually, that's FAME, A. But it sounds better when you just say FAME, so I gotta go with it. So focus. Has anyone ever had binoculars and tried to put binoculars up to your face and look and see everything at one time? Anybody? What happens? Can you see straight? What do you gotta do? Adjust it, right? Adjust it so you can see the one thing that you're focusing on. Now in life, we gotta have our focuses. We gotta have the things that we plan to do that's gonna make us a better person. You know, for me, being a better father, a better businessman, you know, a better inspiration. A, acknowledge. Talk about